all the camps in this area are we're going to have information about all the population, the displaced population that lives here. We have been very early this morning. Our teams have been in the camps, and they have distributed tokens per area and also the bracelets, so that every representative of the family or the household has come, and now they are going to provide detailed information about all the members of the family or the families that live in each shelter.
When we were making the line in the morning, it was crazy. It was 5:30, everybody was here, still dark, mess, you know. With the bracelet, we identify from which camp is, and with the token, we identify the number and the number of the block. And when we are giving the token in the tent, we ask him and we write how many members of the family he has.
The secret is a very good communication on what is the process that is going to happen. Try not to give a lot of expectations. It's just an update on population figures. I think everybody understands that this is helpful for the international community or for the government to have accurate data so that they can respond to their problem. The way we organize these operations, given the amount of staff, the amount of people that is going to be registering or updating their details on the family members that live in the camp, we always ask for the support, and we prepare it in advance, well in advance, on where are we going to be working, what are the entry points, what are the exit points for the families that are being registered. So there is a lot of logistic preparation into this type of operation.